Hi everyone, so I've got Shorty with us from 100% NUFC, and of course he is part of Newcastle Fan TV. We're trying to get him 1,000 subs. He's nearly there, so please head over, pop him a sub. So we're going to be talking about Crystal Palace and what we've got, obviously, to preview. We've also got a Crystal Palace fan coming on as well, so do keep an eye out for that on both of our channels, actually, which is Ollie. But just talking now, the game's ended, everyone's a little bit deflated. You know, we didn't really see the club splash the cash. We've got three loans in. How do we pick ourselves up going into Sunday?
Well, it's hard. It's deflating because the Burnley game last night, we were the better team, and because we don't have the quality, Burnley have come and punished us. You know, and it's a shame, you know, that Hosslew couldn't score the goals. I mean, the penalty, okay, you think it's never easy. You know, the likes of Messi has missed penalties and things like that. But the one in the second half, you know, that was crucial. If he'd scored that 2-0 up, you know, you go on and win the game. But you know, the transfer market wasn't exactly amazing. Yes, we've got Slimani and you know, Dubravka, and obviously Kennedy was amazing last night. I will say that.
Do you think he'll start Sunday?
Yeah, I do. I think he might even play the full 90 minutes. He was looking really good. Yeah, I think the first game, you know, his fitness isn't there, but he might just be drafted in. Played really well, you know, got the penalty for Newcastle, which obviously was missed. But I think we need to not be deflated. It's Crystal Palace, you know, they're there and thereabouts on the table. It's going to be a tough game. Selhurst Park, you know, that Roy Hodgson's really picked them up this season, and I think they're playing some really good stuff. We've got to be wary of how they threaten, how they play against us. But if we just stick to a game plan, anything could happen.
How do you think they will set up? Do you think they'll play 4-3-3 or with Zaha on, because he plays on that like kind of left free role, doesn't he, coming in? Do you think that's obviously the strength that they have?
Yeah, I think so. 4-3-3 would suit them as well. Selhurst Park, they're at home, they're in front of the crowd. You know, he's the main attacking threat. You've got to watch out for him. He's a menace. You know, the pacey, tricky winger who's going to cause the back four problems. So, you know, if Jamal Lascelles is captain, he's got to really be talking to Kieran Clark or whoever decides to play in that back four. And obviously, Dubravka, if he starts, you know, the keeper who we've just signed on loan from Sparta Prague. Bit like Burnley, you know, they've got their main players. We're going to have to watch out for them. Never going to be an easy game. But
what they've got that we don't have, and I've said this on the next video, which has already been recorded, they've got individual talents like Benteke or a Townsend or, you know, a Zaha, whereas they can win a game by single-handedly, whereas we don't have that luxury. We've got like a team ethic that we've got to go and win. Do you think that's a way to win it this weekend, or is there something else? How are we winning this game?
I think we've got to be patient again. I think we've got to go at them. I think it's going to be an attacking game, you know, because both teams are in the middle of the table. We need points. You can class this as a relegation six-pointer because, you know...
Well, it is.
Yeah, anybody, if the top 10 teams could go down, there's no really form in the league. I think Newcastle have just got to go there and give it a all. And, you know, after dropping points against Burnley, this game is huge for Newcastle. And anything less than a point, even a draw, won't be good enough, depending on if other results don't go our way.
Well, obviously, we've got the league table up on screen. And, you know, if we don't pick anything up, you've got Man United visiting us here at St. James' Park, which will be very, very difficult, and we've still got to play some big sides as well. How do we? You've mentioned, obviously, do you think it'll be a very similar, cautious Rafa trying to hit them on the counter? You know, because our away form, we seem to play a little bit better, because obviously the home form, we haven't won, ironically, against Crystal Palace.
Yeah, well, that's again October, wasn't it?
And
yeah.
Then, so, how do you think? Do you think you'll go cautious and try and hit them on the counter, or do you think you'll surprise them and go for it?
I think you've got to go for it. I mean, against a bigger sort of club, you know, like last week I said Chelsea, you know, it's Chelsea, you know, they've got a better team than us on paper. You know, they're obviously in the top six, whereas Crystal Palace, they're in and around us. You've got to go for it. You know, we've got to start picking up points. We need to start messing about now, and we've really got to start doing the business and getting these points, because our home performances haven't been good enough, and we've done better away from home. You know, we've went to West Ham, we've opened up and we've played really well in other games in between. This game is massive. It's massive, not just for this club, but for the players' morale, the confidence. And if we can get a good result at Crystal Palace on Sunday, that will do the world.
Take the pressure off, because away fans are completely different to the home fans.
Yeah.
Away fans are continuously, doesn't matter what the score, singing, cheering, supporting the lads all the way through. We've got to see more of it for me, St. James Park, because there's too many people kick off with a misplaced pass and little things like that. You're all right in saying, because if we don't win this... Well, even that, no, I'll rephrase it. If we win this game, we can afford to lose to Man United, because they're trying to get in the Champions League, and they're not going to catch Man City, of course. But, you know, we've got to, like, try and win. And our records have been pretty decent by a couple of results with teams around us. We've got to pick up 3 points, haven't we?
It's a huge game. You know, Crystal Palace, again, in and around us. If we win against Crystal Palace, that will do the world a good going at the Man United game, because, again, it's a bonus game. Yes, we're at home. If we get a point against Man United, which we'll move on to later on next week, brilliant. But looking at this game, it's huge. It's absolutely huge. And I mean, again, I'll go back to the home performances. They haven't been good enough this season, and we've done better away from home. So we're playing with a freedom at Crystal Palace, you know, with nothing to lose. And after losing, after dropping points against Burnley last night, it's just huge that we'll go there and we'll give it our all. And, you know, if we get a draw, we've played really, really well. And, you know, there's not a lot you can do, fair enough, but it's all about getting the 3 points.
And Roy Hodgson's done a marvellous job since he's gone in there, and he was laughed at, he was mocked.
I said at the start of the season when we were interviewed, right. Ollie, I said that Crystal Palace this season, they'll be in the middle of the table. I said, they'll be fine. I was getting laughed at, you know, I was getting mocked saying, oh no, they'll get relegated.
So why is old owl, isn't he?
Well, because Roy Hodgson, he's been at some really top clubs, you know, he's been at Liverpool, you know, he's been the England manager. Yes, it didn't quite work out, you know, for against Iceland, he got the sack and whatnot, but he's got that managerial know-how, and he's really structured Crystal Palace.
I remember he was Switzerland manager. I remember he was Inter Milan manager twice. Later on this week, obviously, we've got Ollie from Crystal Palace on both of our channels. What else we've got coming up? We've got the podcast. We're actually just about to film that as well. So that'll be on iTunes. It's all about transfers, so it'll be good listen if you're at work or at the gym or whatever. And then, obviously, on Friday, we've got Rafa's press conference. Whiteboard video will probably be out Saturday as well. And then, obviously, the big one on Sunday, let us know how we're going to win this game. Let us know in your comments down there below. Remember, pop out a Sharky, trying to push him over the 1,000 barrier. And once we've got you to 1,000, you can stop asking people to subscribe, can't you?
Well, we're very close. I think we're something like 45 subscribers.
It's not Hellawa. Please, Hellawa.
We're getting there.
If you're watching Newcastle Fans TV, please pop by. See you, bye.